Obama came directly out of the tradition of Martin Luther King and the civil rights movement, and Martin King would be very proud, as I am, of Barack Hussein Obama today.
I want to ask you, what specifically can we do to utilize that nonviolent army organized around the Obama campaign to go forward and make an economic, at the grassroots, basic change in this country can make that dream come alive?
We need to transform, which means we have to lay out some agendas and then use the spending of $1 trillion to be able to achieve those agendas. And it's not going to be for everyone if it's not demanded. And so when you ask how to utilize it, people organize around an agenda for everyone. They need to understand what the policy platforms need to be. They're going to have to educate themselves. Because if this is just a moment in which people are going to just work for their group, to work for themselves, to recover back to what we had with this tremendous gap between the haves and the have-nots, it won't make any of us proud. So educate ourselves, come up with a policy agenda, put our will behind it in the form of a movement, and hold everybody accountable, including the 44th President of the United States.
What happened in the 60s that we cannot repeat is people who do really good, we elevate them to the place where they are national leaders and they leave the communities behind from which they come from. And as a result of that, there is no mechanism, there is no organizing, there is no plan and plan revision over time that keeps the community together around policy priorities. Policies change based on who have the most votes at the table at that time. But movements can be built around priorities that impact policy over time.